Hi there, I'm Eric. I'm a senior designer here at Native Instruments, and I thought as the design lead for Massive X Player, a completely free and slimmed down version of Massive X, it would be fun to be the person that walks you through the new play page and the new Morpher feature that is at the heart of Massive X Player and also now part of Massive X. I had a lot of fun working on the Morpher and the development cycles and playing with early prototypes and user testing them. But during that time, I also could like explore it a little bit deeper and wanted to share a few little fun techniques in the ways that I used it. So let me just open up Massive X. It's already open, right? Yeah. And I also have like a single node here in Ableton that is playing. And over here is a preset browser where I can choose different presets. I have these banks and these bank selectors where I can load my Massive X expansions. There's a bunch of new ones coming out, like really focused on different genres and different sounds. But there's also a free one called Bass Music Essentials that is coming with Komplete Start. And then I have in the middle here, the star of the show, our big Morpher, this Morph pad, which is really, really cool. I'm gonna show you how it sounds in a second. And then this Animator, as well as 8 macro knobs down here. So what can the player and the Morpher do? So when I load up this preset, I stick with this Abori deep one right here. It comes with 4 different macro variations assigned to each of these corners. So you can see just by moving this corner around how these 8 knobs down here shape shift their position. And I can basically morph between them. So how does this sound? I just gonna hit play. Okay, we have this patch comes with this beat, and then you can see how I am interpolating between these values, between these different states, and that's already super fun. But I can also customize this super quick without going into the depth of Massive X. So I can just go up here, maybe go to this corner, and I just hit this random icon, this dice icon. Okay, could do the same here. And what I also can do is I can just take any sound that I like. So for example, I like this setup, turn up the kick a bit, a little bit more reverb, basically everything full to the right. Yeah, and then when I hit this icon, this is the snapshot icon, then that setting that I have dialed in with those macros will be attached to that corner. So. And now I can just morph between them again. All right, but that's not all. I also have this animator here where we can make this cursor, or we call it the little wisp because it's this cute little firefly. Anyways, I can turn on this animator, and basically what's happening, the cursor is gonna move on these predefined paths that we created for it. There will be some updates where you can like change the size and rotate them. Didn't make it in the release yet, but you can choose different complexities of these curves. Let's go with this rose petal here, for example, and you can make this faster. You can also sync the tempo to the host BPM, and then you get these time signatures to get it a bit more musically. And you can also reverse this like so. What you can also do is if you have more than one node, you can set it to re-trigger, and then it re-triggers in every note hit. Okay, let's look at our first example here. I have a project prepared with a bunch of chords on this track, and I'm just gonna play these chords for you so you can listen to them without the animator and without the Morpher being turned on. And then I would just like move around a little bit so you get this idea of how this could sound. So we have Massive X open here, the preset. Yeah, almost makes me cry. No, and seriously, I can like, you can see how it sounds like different when I move this around. But what I do then is I just turn on this animator and I have it set really slow. And you can hear how it just like creates a little bit more movement in this chord progression. And I've done the same thing with this track here on the side where I just have a bunch of bass. So let me just, come on, we do a fade in. Let me just fade this in. And again, it's quite static at the moment. But also here, I just prepared the animator to go quite slow. Also a little bit offbeat, you know, I didn't sync it to the host tempo. I just said, okay, go slow, maybe a bit slower even. And now I just have these two loops and they're just evolving over time and they're animating in the sound and the sound is like subtly changing over the course of the loop. And while this is happening, I also have a kick running. And for that kick, I created an automation. So this is the kick solo without automation. And you can see I can move this around. And what I wanted to have is like, I wanted to have like a different kind of kick sound, kick style on each of these hits. So I created this envelope for the kick. I can see each of these coordinates here is jumping around. So what you're doing is basically you go into your envelopes in your DAW and you choose the Morpher X value and the Morpher Y value, and then you can either draw your automations or you can record automations directly from the Morpher interface here in Massive X, and then you can use those to get like, here you can see it as well, to get like these different animated sounds. And now everything together, let's see how that sounds. Right, in this next example, I have a preset called Deep Cutter loaded up in Massive X. And this is part of the 140 bass expansion. Shout out to my man Tony from Sound Design. This is a pretty cool expansion. And as we did with the last example, I just gonna play these few notes here with the bass line. I also have a drum track, a very simple drum track running in the background. Just have a quick listen to it and you can see what happens when I move the Morpher cursor around. So that's pretty cool. As you can see, or maybe you've heard it, there are these two macros right here, LFO shape and LFO rate, that change the sound of the the wobbliness of that patch. And I could, as I said in the beginning already, I can also turn those off. So when I move this around, I'm not changing the rate anymore. So I have the same shape and the same rate across the whole patch the whole time. I can manually control them, of course. But what I can also do, and I've prepared this already, is I can write automation for it. I could just record this with an external device, or I just draw some curves. This is what I have done really quickly. So if I show this to you over here, we don't only have the Morpher X and Y parameters that we can automate, but we also have all of these macros down here. Also pitch bend, mod wheel, and aftertouch are quite new. So yeah, if I select this, you can see macro 7, which is this guy here. It's automated like this, and macro 8 is automated like that. And you can see how these macros jump around. But now the animator is off, so let's just see what happens when I turn this guy on. So you can see I have this quite simple sine shape here. It's going quite fast. You can also just see how it sounds if I make this a bit more complex. Slower. As you can see, I can also put this to re-trigger and just see what happens there. Maybe just go to this line. To get a bit more predictable results. And you just play around until you find something nice. But we are going to the next example. All right, the next trick that I'm going to show you is one of my favorites. It's basically a round robin kind of trick where every single note trigger randomizes whatever happens on the Morpher. It's something that you can't do in the Morpher itself yet, but to prototype this internally, we kind of played around with different solutions, and basically you can do this in any DAW. I used a bunch of different plugins to achieve that. In Ableton, there is this plugin called Expression Control. So you just hit Command F or Control F on Windows, and then you type in You should type it like this. And then you can see there is this Expression Control device. I think Ableton 10.11 was the first time it had it as a stock device in there. Once you loaded this into your Massive X track, like I have them here, you have to make sure to choose Random here and Random there. You need two. You need one for the x-axis, one for the y-axis. Then you have this little target thing here. You just hit map to x, map to y. And now when I play this, gonna turn this off for a moment. Now when I play this, you can hear how this sounds first. Beautiful Brahm sound. God. I don't know about you, but I think Massive X sounds absolutely amazing, especially for redlining. Don't be like me, don't redline. Also, this multiband compressor that we have there as an effect, if you have the Massive X full version, just create a bunch of macros with that little device here, the multi compressor. It's so powerful. Let's go back to the play mode, and now I'm just going to turn on my expression control and play the same patch again. And you can see on every note that is being hit, my Morpher jumps to a different position and it sounds a little bit different. Of course, you can also do this with percussive stuff in Massive X. So over here, I've done the same thing. We're just gonna solo this for a moment. I've done the same thing, expression control is turned off. This is over here, you can see Perk Chaos Engine is the preset that I'm using, and I hit play. I have a bunch of notes here. Let me get rid of those because we don't need to look at them. And then we fold this again, so it's only these notes. Now let's add the randomizer. Right? And lastly, we just combine this all with a nice little kick. And then we get something that sounds like this. Just for the sake of the demo, let me turn off all the randomization stuff. I can move this around. But you know what I mean? Like a lot of this like liveliness is just gone. So let's put it back in. And then we go to the next example. Okay, we are at the end of the video, and I just want to show you one more thing where I try to use a bunch of Massive X instances. I think it's 8 Massive X instances where I used the player, and just walk you through how I would create a track with that. I used a bunch of like stock devices, not a bunch, just a few, like a little bit of compression and stuff, but I don't use effects, I don't use descend effects and all that. So yeah. What do we have here? First of all, we have the Massive X lead sound. Let me try to find that window right here. So let me solo this guy. This is basically just a build-up, if I remember correctly. It's called Low Rumbles. You can just see, just a little. Even make that a bit slower. It's just one note playing the whole time. Same thing is going on here, channel 6. Just this guy. For this, I actually recorded a bunch of automations, just live, as you can see here. I just hit record and I moved this cursor around with my mouse. Pretty cool. Then we have another little break point here. So this is number 7. How do you sound? Oh yeah, I set up the corner and the speed to kind of hit the bottom right at the end of that MIDI clip. And now it goes back. And that was it for this one. I do have a few leads, also just really short loops, as you can see here. Let's see how this sounds. That is number 5. It's this guy here. Turn the animator off. Now it's a single note that is playing. See, I can move this around, turn the animator on, and the single note gives me a little bit more breathing again. And then this kick up here is also Massive X. Up here, I just turned the animator on, show you the different settings. And I didn't want them to be so extreme. This is why I turned the animator on that circle, so it's never hitting the outside edges. So it's never gonna be that extreme sound, but the kick is changing slightly in the background. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I could help you and inspire you a little bit. I hope you check out Massive X Player. It's free, so you can check it out for free. Like I said, there's a bunch of expansions coming with it. You cannot build your own patches, unfortunately. For that, you need Massive X, the full version. But yeah, just check it out, have some fun, play with the presets, and leave me some comments what you think of it, and also what kind of features you might want to see in the future. So let me just hit play here, and I say goodbye to y'all.